So returning to our table model here, the next step is to add some legs. And what we actually want to do is only model out one leg and then repeat it using the mirror tools to the other three corners of the table. So let's start by doing a very simple extruded straight leg. And we can do that by starting a sketch down at the bottom face of the table. Doesn't matter which corner we're on. And I'm just going to do a leg like this. Let's dimension it. So maybe 3 inches square and 2 inches away from each edge. This gives me a profile that I can extrude down. Let's add an extrude feature. 30 inches should be good. Maybe 32 actually. And I'm going to uncheck merge result because I don't want this body to be the same body as the tabletop. I'm going to use the mirror tools to manipulate this body independently. So by unchecking merge result, the new extrusion will be a separate body from what already exists in the model. So I click OK there. Now what I'd like to do is shape the leg a bit. In a way that is analogous to how you might shape a leg on a lathe in a workshop. So in order to do that, I'm going to need to draw a profile that is right in the middle of the leg, and I'm going to need a new reference plane to do that. So I'm going to insert reference geometry plane, and what I want is I'm going to use the parallel plane at a point method of defining a plane. So I'm going to select my, it looks like my right plane will work, and then I'm going to select the midpoint of this bottom edge of the leg here, and that gives me enough information to define a plane that cuts right through the middle of the leg, which is what I want. So I'll click OK there. Now we're going to draw a profile of the leg as it might be turned on a lathe. So I'm going to start a new sketch with this new plane selected. First thing I'll do is draw a center line, which is where the leg would be turned, or the axis of revolution on the leg. And now I'm going to just draw a profile that would be cut out on the lathe. So let's see. Maybe I'll start with a gentle sweep in from the rectangular part. I've got this thing in the way here because my screen is so small. Something like this. Maybe I'd have... That's probably too large. A circle like this. Let's make this a uniform dimension, so maybe a 1-inch circle there. Oops. I need to zoom up more. There. Get that away from the edge. I want a similar circle down here on the same vertical line, so I'm going to give myself some construction geometry here. Let's do another circle down here that is also 1 inch. Okay. And, oh, you know what? That looks like it's going to be too large. It's going out beyond the edge of my stock here. Let's do a 3/4 inch. Okay, now in the main part of the leg, I think I just want a very gentle sweep, so I'm going to do a spline. Whoops. Okay, and let's just bulge that out a bit. Like this. Okay, and then we'll do kind of the same thing down towards the bottom here. this out a bit as well. Okay. So this is basically the profile that I want to cut away from this on the lathe. And I need to make this a closed contour, so I'm going to close this off just using my line tool. Okay. So I'm going to exit this sketch. And now, oops, you know what? I forgot to do something. I need to edit the sketch again because I need to trim away the inside of these circles here. Use my trim tool. Okay. So now I've got a single closed profile here that I'm going to use the revolved cut feature on to remove material with. So I'm going to insert a revolved cut. Oh, I had forgotten to select my sketch, so I'm going to do that now. And my center of my axis of revolution is going to be this center line here. And so what's happened now is it's revolved that profile and cut that material away from the leg, just like you would do on a lathe. It's not a very refined form, but I think you can see what's being done there. So I'm just going to call this leg lathe cut. Okay, so now we've got this leg in one of the four corners of the table, and we need to repeat it to the others. The easiest way to do that is going to be with a mirror feature, or actually a pair of mirror features. So let's hide this plane here since we don't need it. I basically want to reflect the leg across the middle of the table here so that there's one on the other side over in this corner. And in order to do that, I'm going to need a plane going across the middle of the table. I can define that plane just like I defined the plane for my lathe cut here, using the parallel plane at a point. So again, insert, reference geometry, plane. I need to find the parallel plane, which is going to be my right plane. And I need to select the point where I want it to the new plane to come out. And so I hover over my edge here, and there's the midpoint. Okay. So that defines this plane. Now I can insert my mirror feature. So I go to Insert, Pattern Mirror, Mirror. I don't want to do features to mirror because this leg here is actually a body. So I want to go down here to Bodies to Mirror, so that I'm selecting a body, and click on my leg. You can see that it brings a ghost image of the leg reflected across the plane that I had selected, the mirror plane here. So I can hit OK. Now I've got a copy of the leg mirrored across this plane. You can see that the mirror is a feature just like an extrude or a revolve or anything else, and that's what creates this second leg here. If I go past it, it goes away. Okay. So now I want to take these two legs and mirror them across another plane. So this one is going to be parallel to my front plane. Again, insert, reference geometry, plane. My front plane is the plane it should be parallel to, and I need to select the midpoint along this edge. Okay. So now my plane 5 I want to use to reflect both of these legs. So again, insert, pattern mirror, mirror. My mirror face or plane is going to be plane 5 here. My bodies to mirror are going to be this leg and this leg. Okay, and now I've got 4 legs on the table. Just get these planes out of the way with hide. And we have a table that can stand up.